There is a lot of talk about fake news. So today, we're going to look at how to spot fake news, how to spot a credible source, and what resources CALS has to help you discern the credible from the not so trustworthy. First, let's talk about what the phrase credible source means. According to dictionary.com, the word credible means capable of being believed, believable. A source is where we go to attain our information. Whether you are performing your own research through polling or experimentation, or reading someone else's work to use in your research. Putting the two ideas together, we can conclude that a credible source is work being cited that is found to be trustworthy. There are several questions you can ask to determine the credibility of a source. We've broken them down into four larger groups of questions. What is the purpose of this source? Is this information current or out of date? Who is the author of this source? And where did this source come from? Let's start with our first question. What is the purpose of this source? One of the first things to do when analyzing a source is to decide what the purpose of the piece is. Does it seem like the source is trying to persuade you, or is it stating information and letting you decide what it means? Where did the author get their information? Did they do the research themselves, or are they a secondary source? Are they being financially supported by an organization or an individual? If so, what do they advocate? By identifying the purpose of the source, you may be able to tell if it's meant to persuade you to the opinion of the author, or if it's providing the information without bias. Next, we'll ask, is this information current or out of date? You want to use the best information available. Sometimes historical information can be useful, but you need all information to be relevant. Especially when dealing with constantly changing subjects such as healthcare or technology, be mindful of the age of the source. Recent information will serve you best in these fields. Another question to ask is, who is the author of this source? Is this person or organization respected in the field they are addressing? If not, think twice about trusting them. Sometimes sources will claim to have expertise in a subject, but have little to no standing in the field they speak on. It only takes a few minutes to look someone up on the internet to try to find their background. Often, people who have done extensive work in a field are somewhat easy to find on the internet using a couple of keywords and their name. Finally, where did the source come from? Did your source come from a chat forum or Wikipedia? Though these are fine to help you pick a direction for your research, these are not credible sources. Anyone can input, edit, and falsify information on a site such as these. Also, be wary of sources with limited citable information. If it is missing a date, author, and title, there's a good chance it is not credible. However, if you can find two or three other sources with the same information, chances are that you have information that is reputable. The Central Arkansas Library System has a collection of databases to help you sort fact from fiction. Browse peer-reviewed books in our Gale Virtual Library and peer-reviewed journal articles in ProQuest Central. You can access our databases by visiting cals.org and exploring the Learn tab. We also have classes you can take to help you learn better research techniques on our Who Knew It and Universal Class learning platforms. You can find quick access to these also under the Learn tab. In this time when we are questioning what is real and not real, it is important that each of us do our part to take a few extra minutes to verify our sources. Are you going to trust a meme to give you the facts about the coronavirus or someone who has actually studied and worked with infectious diseases? Look into your sources and use your best judgment on whether or not you are dealing with a truly credible source. Sorting fact from fiction is one of the ways you can experience the library rewritten at CALS. Visit CALS.org to learn more today.